today, I'm going to talk to you about true occult knowledge. You know, the wisdom of a true wise man, of a real druid. You know, some of the earliest priests. Leaders, spiritual leaders, fucking shamans. So many different words for it. Sorcerers, wizards, witches, warlocks. That's also using the secret dub. There should be 7 vowels instead of the 5 we know. So we need the 7 vowels. Actually, become harmonic with the universe. But anyway, that's another subject for another day. Today I'm talking about who is the first wise man, first person to think about spirit. Well, to me, first bookkeepers, astronomers, you know, first motherfuckers that really wanted to know knowledge, you know. First mathematicians. First geometry majors, whatever the fuck you want to call that shit. It was the farmer. The farmer's the one who needed to keep track of the stars. You know, when to plant his crops. When to harvest his crops. When crops won't even fucking grow because it's gonna be too cold. So he was the first one to start writing that shit down. Well, if you really get into deep occult shit, and yeah. Some of y'all think y'all were, you know, into deep occult shit. Y'all don't even know. Some of these fucking big-time Mason motherfuckers don't even know. I was raised on that shit. My great-grandmother used to be an invited speaker to the Theosophical Societies back in the days, man. Like, I got all her books, man. You know? I got books y'all motherfuckers ain't even heard of. You know what I'm saying? So if y'all really, really, really want to study some shit, look up some of these titles I'm showing you right now. You know, if you don't understand lots and lots of shit, you gotta read everything. But anyway, her mother, my great-grandmother, who, you know, used to speak at the Theosophical Society, her mother was a pioneer, started some of the first schools in, started the first school in Scottsbluff, Nebraska. That's just like, I don't know, 300 miles from me. It ain't that far. You know, so, you know, if her mother was into teaching, starting schools, and she was, you know, a guest speaker, in, you know, invited from fucking, I think they lived in Casper, Wyoming or some shit. And used to get invited to fucking Chicago to speak for, you know, mass groups of people. You know, she knew what some things she was talking about. Well, her son, my grandfather, Raymond P. McConnell. Here, I'll get a picture of him. He's passed on, but I'll show y'all what he looked like. grandfather looked like before he passed. That old hippie. He'd like to live as a bum. He'd live on, you know, Sand Creek here in Aurora, Colorado. He's living the fuck sewers in New York with the, what he called the mole people. Yes. You know, he used to run around and do all kinds of crazy drug dealing shit in California back in the 70s and shit. Probably ate more acid than any of you motherfuckers. A lot of people thought he was a spiritual guru or some kind of shaman himself. See, Grandpa had seizures. He got hit in the head with a snowball that either, he can't remember if it was an ice chunk or a rock, but, you know, he was up in Casper, Wyoming, and got hit in the head with his snowball in a snowball fight with a kid that cheated, he said, and woke up in Denver 2 weeks later. Well, ever since then, he had narcolepsy and epileptic seizures. So, Grandpa was asleep a lot. And, you know, seizures made him fall asleep. And Grandpa was into all this occult knowledge and shit, because, you know, of course, fucking, you know, his parents were, you know, he was raised on the shit just as I was. And, he used to tell me about astral travel. His astral travels. And he used to tell me there's this light that comes out of the top of the pyramid. He said, don't go into that light. Anybody he ever seen go into that light never got to come back. Now I've been seeing all these videos of don't go into the light. It's a trap. It helps you get reincarnated and have to come back. So, I don't know. I wonder if these motherfuckers on the video got it wrong. And you shouldn't go into that light, though. My grandpa was deathly afraid of that light. He told me, do not go into that light. I don't know why he was telling me this one time. This is, you know, the last time I seen him before he died, he was telling me this shit. And like I said, I learned the light is a trap. If the light's a trap, how do you get to God? Go into the darkness. See, if you believe that, like a lot of these people are believing that the devil flipped everything around on us, then yes, the light and the angels is false. You don't want to go there. I don't know what it is, but you don't want to go there. Okay? And the darkness would be God. Mathematics, I've said in a previous video, explains God. You know, zero, nothing. Is all. It's everything. Because every positive and negative number starts at that point, zero. So nothing, or the blackness out there in space. See, I mean, the light has to come from somewhere. Light needs energy. You have to have energy to create light, whether it's fire, electricity, even electricity, light bulbs, the way we know it, is still fire, because it's just gases burning inside that light bulb. So once you understand all this shit, and you realize the light is just another being, it's not God. Makes you really wonder what the fuck's going on, huh? So to be with the infinite, you have to go to the nothing. You see what I'm saying? Because the nothing is everything. Now if that don't make sense, then y'all need to do some gardening. Sit around and farm and think about this shit. Because also, when you get into all this occult knowledge, they tell you that the blood is the life force. Blood is the life force. Yeah. So what's the fountain of youth? Some say drinking blood keeps them young. That's been a vampire secret, fucking sick. Kings and queens of the past have fucking, you know, bathed in virgin's blood and all this shit. Sacrificed babies in the satanic church. All this shit for the blood. The blood is that life force, right? Well, What's the opposite of love? That would be chlorophyll. It'd be the blood of the plant. So the blood of the plant is the fountain of youth, the most sacred life force. That's why vegetarians and vegans always look so fucking healthy. Because they've tapped into the life force. Well, anyway, I don't know, maybe I rambled on a little bit here, but I think I made all my points that I wanted to make. So, you know. Be wary of the light. This is what I'll say. The light definitely is a trap. My grandfather told me this, and I've seen all kinds of videos on this. So, anyway. Stay high, folks. Stay high. Don't let them fuck with you. Don't pay taxes. Don't vote for any of these motherfuckers. Write in Charles Manson on your ballot, because he'd be a better president than any of these bitches. Later.